Hi guys, and welcome to today's video. Today's video is a no foundation, no makeup makeup look. If you're new to my channel, welcome to my channel. I'm Anam. I put up content from fashion, beauty, travel, and a lot of daily vlogs, apart from some fun videos with my husband as well. If you are already a subscriber, thank you so much for being part of my subscriber fam. If you're not, go ahead and join the subscriber fam right about now and turn those bell notifications on, and hopefully you will enjoy a lot of my upcoming videos. Today's video is about that minimal makeup look that is perfect to achieve on a daily basis between a tight schedule, if you're really crazy busy, if you just prefer minimal makeup, or if you're someone who just has that video call you need to attend while we're all at home and you just want to make sure you look really nice and presentable. This is going to be really simple, a little bit technique driven, because I want you guys to be able to get a really nice look with minimal steps. That's the idea. So let's not make this introduction any longer and let's dive right into this. Okay, so to begin with, I want to tell you that I'm going to avoid giving you a mini review of every product, because these are products I have talked about in multiple videos in the past. What I will do for sure is list them for you guys down below in the info box. Naturally, I cannot add links at the moment because we're all on lockdown and no e-commerce sites are kind of on right now. But I will go ahead and add the links once all of this changes, so you can check back later if you're looking to shop them at a later time when we all can. Let's begin with the makeup. First off, I'm going to begin with the prepping, because I don't believe you can do anything without your skin being prepped, even if it's just like 5 or 6 products that you're about to throw onto your face. I have an oil as well as a primer with me here today, and I'm gonna go ahead and start to prep my face. While prepping your face, just keep in mind that you want to make sure your skin feels hydrated and feels soft and supple. That is the number one formula to making sure any makeup look you do, or even just your skin in general without makeup, looks as well as feels really nice and healthy. With your primer, I would recommend just a little bit of extra detailing around your nose, nostrils, on your under eyes, and on any other concerned spots that you have on your face basis your skin. One of the things that a lot of people tend to forget while prepping their face are their lips. You've looked after your skin, you want to make sure you take care of your lips as well. So go ahead and add that lip balm, because your lips also need that nourishment to look healthy. Now, normally this is around the time I would dive into my foundation, but I'm not using a foundation today. We're keeping this look really, really minimal. What we're going to do is dive straight into the concealer. So take the concealer of your choice. I prefer liquid concealers, especially because I have dry skin and I find it much easier to blend than anything with an excessively creamy or cakey consistency. And I'm going to apply this concealer around my under eyes. Now, keep one thing in mind. You want to apply absolutely minimal concealer. You can always build up if you want to, because unlike the normal times when you're probably wearing a foundation, your concealer does not have a foundation, also known as a base, literally, to blend into. So you want to make sure that the concealer is there just a little bit to brighten up those under eyes, conceal those dark circles, but at the same time looking minimal and natural. Don't forget to go on your lids as well, because you want to make sure that your pigmentation is completely cut off from both sides. Three very important things that I'm going to highlight over here is that A, don't forget about the innermost corner of your eye, because that's really important. That can completely make or break the way your eye area looks. Secondly, I will say don't forget to go around your mouth if you have a little bit of grayness like I do. This is something I pay special attention to, because I do have the grayness around my mouth like I do on my under eyes as well. And thirdly, you saw me going over a few other areas with the concealer, which are my concern spots. So if you have scars, pigmentation, any kind of pimples, you can definitely go ahead and use your concealer over that as well for a little bit of correction. The next step I'm going to do is actually really, really optional. You can or can skip wearing setting powder. If you're someone who has oily skin, you probably don't want to skip this. At the same time, even though I have dry skin, my under eyes tend to crease really, really easily. So I am going to take a little bit of loose powder, apply it on my under eyes, and then immediately stroke away any excess. I'm not looking to bake at all, because I'm looking for a minimal makeup look. I'm just swiping away and pushing away as a combination of movements with this beauty blender to make sure if there's any excess product, it moves away, and any product that needs to go into my crease lines to avoid it from creasing also gets pushed into the right places. As you can see, this one step completely transforms the way the under eyes look, which is the number one thing why one tends to look tired. Or I know there are times when I don't wear any makeup and my friends are like, are you not feeling well? It is that one thing that really makes you look really tired and exhausted. Covering your under eyes and instantly more than half your job, not just half your job, is done. We're gonna go into the eyebrows next. Now, typically, I would take a pencil, feather them out, and then maybe go in with a gel or something to set my brows in. Today, it's gonna be a one product thing. I have an eyebrow mascara over here, and because we're looking for a really no fuss makeup look, I'm just gonna go ahead and stroke this through. Not really gonna fill. What I'm instead gonna focus on is the areas that I would normally fill with a product. I'm just gonna probably put a couple of extra strokes on. But I'm going to keep it really simple and easy to do. Eyebrows are something we've skipped out on doing for so many years. People have started really looking at their eyebrows once again only a few years ago. They are a game changer. They are something that once they're done and neatly tucked into place, you immediately look more groomed. It is the truth of it. So don't skip out on your eyebrow. That 30-second thing will completely change the way your eye area looks. Okay, I'm gonna come into the face next. We can do the eyes a little bit later. Now, this is a little bit of an up to you kind of a situation. I would normally go in with a contour or a bronzer, but I am doing a minimal makeup look today, so I'm gonna be skipping out on it. Instead, I'm taking my blush, and blush is something you really shouldn't skip out on because you need to add a little bit of color to your cheeks to look like, you know, naturally flushed. So just take that brush and a couple of strokes on the apples of your cheeks while you smile. We'll do the highlight after we do the eyes. I know my makeup order is a little bit messed up. I keep going from the face to the eyes and back again. It's just that I go in the way my face, I think, looks best, in a way that you look a little bit complete here and then you look a little bit complete here. And I kind of like go and fill into all the incomplete spots that come to me step by step more organically instead of just sectioning them for the sake of it. So my technique for the eyeshadow is really, really easy. I want to go into one really nice nude shade, and I'm gonna take a super fluffy eyeshadow brush. I'm not gonna take something that's flat or anything. This is something that has a nice round edge, which is gonna make for an easier way of blending, so I don't have to keep shifting brushes, because you want to do this quickly and nicely. Once I've taken that neutral color on, I'm just gonna go in and cover the entire lid with it. Make sure that the nude shade you're taking goes nicely with your skin. Don't just go for anything that looks nude or looks, you know, minimal. It needs to go nicely with your skin color, your skin shade, your skin tone, because you want it to look seamlessly like you're almost like not wearing any shadow. But you do want to wear shadow because your eyelids do need some powder to hold everything in place, because you did put concealer on it earlier and you just look more put together with these little details, so it's worth the effort. You can go all over your lid, you can go into your socket as well, and maybe also just below your brow bone if the shade matches your skin tone as well as this does for me. Now for the highlighter, of course, you're probably going to go in and apply it on your cheeks and on the high points of your face. If you want to add a little bit of reflect and a very subtle glam vibe, I'm definitely going to use it. You can completely skip the highlighter if you want. What I'm also going to do actually is go a tiny step further, take a little bit of highlighter on a, like a little tip brush, and go into the inner corners. This is not a pigmenty thing, it's just something that's going to instantly reflect the inner corner, giving it a very, very, very subtle glam vibe, because your entire eye is so plain. We're skipping the eyeliner because I'm going for a minimal vibe. I'm usually a huge wing liner girl. If you're someone who wants to skip the wing liner, wants to skip the liner completely and keep the eye looking bare, this is a great way to keep your eye looking bare, because you can actually have that very little hint, that little accent that's going to make your eye look just a tad bit glamorous. Then I'm gonna take that same highlighter and apply it on the high points of my face. I'm not gonna go and build up the highlighter like I normally would. I'm gonna leave it really natural. Finish off your eyes with a little bit of mascara. This will make your eyes look open and will instantly make you look awake and groomed up. And it's time to complete this look with a nice nude lippy that will just tie all of this in together so nicely. Remember that whether you have a little bit of makeup or a full-blown makeup look, you should always use some setting spray to help make that makeup keep in place for much longer. It'll help everything blend in and just seamlessly go into your skin sort of over a period of time, and it'll look as natural as possible. Okay, there you have it. The final look is ready. This is a really, really easy to put together minimal look, guys. If I wasn't recording a video right now, this would take me like 5, maybe 7 minutes to do this look. I'm sure it would be the same for you as well. If you do try to create this no makeup, no foundation, very minimal makeup look, please go ahead and let me know down below in the comments. Don't forget to tag me on Instagram as well. I'm really active on Instagram and I would love for you guys to follow me there. I put up a lot of daily stories, BTS, just snippets of my life in general. So come along through that journey, and hopefully you guys have already hit that like button on this video and turn those bell notifications on for more of my upcoming videos. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I love you all so much. Bye.